Okay, I'd like to do another video on a product I got at Dollarama. This is a garden handsaw. It's ParkSide brand, which I don't know who sells that or anybody sells that. This is high quality carbon steel blade with triple ground teeth. The blade retracts into the handle. We'll look at it here a little closer. I have tried it a tiny bit. We'll talk about it. Some issues it has. Let's see. Ideal for cutting fresh wood such as branches, hedges, shrubs. High quality carbon steel blade, it says. Retractable saw blade with safety lock. Ergonomic handle with soft grip. So, and it's in multiple languages. It says made in China on here somewhere. Pretty sure it did. Mentioned some company in Germany, but I'm pretty sure it's made in China. Anyway, it was $4 because that's basically the maximum price of stuff at Dollarama, so some of their sort of better-ish stuff, it's $4. So anyway, open it up. So the normal saw that I usually carry around the woods is this here. It's a Baco Expert, I think was the brand of the model of it. It's pretty similar to like the, was it Laplander, the green sort of colored one. This one's more, I don't know, pruning saw, or I guess it has a different type of blade than the other one, or saw, I don't know. There's minor differences or something. I think it used to say Expert or something on the blade here, but it's pretty good, and it's nice for the woods. It's orange, so if you drop it, and I just tie it onto my backpack or my side bag or whatever, and it cuts really well. I've done tests where I compared it to like the Silky saw, and this isn't as fast, but it's, you know, it's nice, and it's in the Dutch eight locks. And well, anyway, they're I forget what the price on those are, but a whole lot more than $4. So I was. Think of it, like, if this thing was any good at all, it would be well worth the $4. If you lost it, who cares? And a small little saw is like a really good little tool for in the woods. We don't use it a whole lot. It doesn't really matter if it's a little bit dodgy, but it seems like it has fairly good. The plastic here is, you know, like, doesn't feel like the stuff they make like dinky cars out of, or the CBC shotgun, the hinge part on the stock or whatever. It doesn't, feels like a sort of a better-ish quality plastic. It's got a little clip here so you can clip it on the stuff. And then it's a sliding thing and the blade is inside there. So it's a fairly safe little thing. So you gotta kind of push on it a little bit, pull this out, and you can slide the blade out, which this one's fairly stiff, but I tried sort of cleaning it up a little bit in this groove here, because you can see where they were going at it with like a knife. It must have had little bits of the plastic sticking up from when they formed it, but whatever. See, it's fairly stiff, but it's not going to come out on its own. And then you push it there and it locks in. It does say some stuff on the blade. Let's see. It mentions some place in Germany. It was made in the first month of 2021, apparently. VPA, I don't know what that stuff means. Got a 16 centimeter blade. It's 6.29 inches, apparently. So, anyway, yesterday I took it out and I was cutting on some little branches like this, As soon as it gets in about this far, it basically binds. So if you look at the teeth, they're basically all in line. Like they do look well, like sharpened, like they're well cut. They just they have no set to them, which was sort of a similar issue I had with like that Dollarama bow saw. Like the teeth were all in line. So it's basically, anybody that doesn't know how it works, like if the teeth are in line, usually they, like the kerf, like the thing they, the groove they cut in the wood, if it doesn't, if it's not, doesn't, the teeth don't cut it a little bit wider than what the blade is, then as soon as it starts, blade starts getting into the, whatever material or cutting into, it'll bind, because this'll rub, it causes friction, and the blade isn't that thick, so you end up bending the blade and stuff. But so if the teeth are a little bit, if they zigzag back and forth, then it makes that kerf wider, so then the remainder of the blade that follows behind doesn't bind. So that, anyway, but you can, there's tools made to fix that. Like if you look at this one, you know, better saws, it's, so that's one sort of good way to see if a saw is actually decent quality or not. Like if you know, like a $4 Chinese saw at the dollar store sort of, but you can, I don't know if you can see it on there or not, but the teeth, they go back and forth. And apparently the set is, like the tooth is sharpened on one side, has a bevel, and then it's flat on the other side. The tooth is bent away from that sharpened side, so I'll just, I think that was the same with the other saw that I sort of fixed, because I have a setting tool over in the barn. So I'll go ahead, so there'll be, I guess it would be a part two, or maybe I'll just splice it onto this. Probably a better idea. Put it all in one video. So I'll go ahead and give these teeth a little bit of a set. See if that improves it. In other examples or other saws that we've had, or other people have had, that when they just, like cheap bow saws, like some of the ones from Home Hardware and stuff, that if you just bend the teeth back and forth with a pair of pliers, and you don't even have like a real set tool, and they go from can't cut anything to they work, you know, pretty good. Like they're not great, but anyway, so we'll try to fix this, and then I guess I'll just splice it onto this video, and we'll cut some branches and whatever. So if it's fixable, I think it's still well worth the $4. If it's not fixable, then it's kind of a, whatever, it's totally, like I wouldn't take it in the woods and carry it around. It's, like if you cut anything bigger than that, it's basically useless. So, but it's like nice and super light, it's fairly safe, because you can, lead back in the handle, and you can, you could, I don't know, I guess you could put the, I guess this little clip is not too bad, a little string on it or something, tie it on to something. I don't know if you can really put anything else. Because you can drill a hole here or put a lanyard on there too, but because with this little, when it clips on here, you kind of push it to get it to come out, so it doesn't, it's not going to come out on its own. And well, this one here anyway, it's not going to, like you got to force it, so it won't get that far anyway, so it's pretty safe even if you carried it this way. But if you carry it that way, then gravity's kind of helping you keep it closed. But anyway, so we'll see if we can, if it's fixable or not. So they had a whole like giant big box of them at Dollarama, or my Dollarama, so I'm kind of hoping that it works, because it does feel decent. It's just, I don't know why they don't set the teeth. Like, that's not really difficult. It's not like it's rocket surgery or anything to how a saw works, but I think it'd be a great little, you know, you can leave one at the camp, put one in your truck, put, you know, there's a branch in the road, you can, you know, you get cut through. Might take a while, but if it cuts, you know, it looks like it's sharpened well. I don't know how, if it's, I doubt it's hardened very well. This isn't as carbon steel blades, but anyway, doesn't mean a whole lot sometimes. But anyway, I'm just rambling now, so.